Yesterday we have discussed regarding casting, casting and non-casting. So we have some rules for the casting. Okay, so first rule, the cast operation type and source type should have the inheritance relationship, or else it needs to be a compile time error, incompatible type. So yesterday we have already seen this. So one question is there in the interview, what is the class cast exception? How it is going to, this is different thing, but here what is the class cast exception? In the casting, the object are coming from source variable. I will give you the example of this object, what is the source variable. Here it will get more clarity about of that. Okay, just we'll see this document here. Then what happened? In casting, the object are coming from source variable. If it is not compatible with the cast operator type, understood, then JVM will throw class cast exception. So yesterday we had already seen this. So in casting, compiler cannot identify the object coming from source variable. Okay. So class cast exception will throw at a runtime. Compiler, we are able to compile, yesterday we have seen, but that's why I mentioned here, in the casting, compiler cannot identify the object are coming from source variable. This is, what is the meaning of this type, which type it is, the compiler is not able to find this. This is the job of the JVM. Okay, JVM is finding this, where it's coming from source variable, because it check only the source variable type, cast operation type has a EJS relationship or not. So when the source variable is superclass type and cast operator is subclass type, then compiler always compile this casting. But if the object are object or a variable is a sibling type or cast operator type, then JVM will throw exception. So yesterday we had already seen this, all this example. Okay, just we have given this example, what is going to happen here. So we have took one example here and we are going to explore this. In the above statement, we have this statement, then compiler only check the obj and d has a relationship or not. Obj means reference variable or not. It does not check the object source obj variable, because the compiler check only type the variable, since the both type have the inheritance relation or relationship, and compiler allow above the conversion, but the runtime JVM identify the object are coming from obj variable, okay, of that type A, which is not compatible with D. Hence JVM terminate the program execution by throwing the class cast exception. So this is your story of casting. Go through once all the documentation and example, it will get more clarity. Okay, in how many ways we can access the one class member of another class. Okay, so how to access from one class member of another class, this is a different topic. In two ways we can access one class member to another class, by using the class name or object class, object name. So we have a hazard relationship, this is called hazard relationship, by using the inheritance, which means the subclass or object class type. So what is the meaning of this? I will give you the example. So this is one example, class A. So we can access A class member in the two ways. So these are the classes there, how we can access by two ways. So we have a static and we have a non-static, right? Two variables are there, static or non-static. A static member can be accessed using the class. We know non-static member we can access by using the object. Okay, so what I want to tell you here, this example, what I want to tell you, how to access this class A. So you can access by using this, can see the class A, this member I'm going to access by using the class A only. So how to access? One is the static, one is the non-static, right? So simply as static, you can directly you can display this by using the class name, and non-static you have to create an object, and using this reference variable we can access this. Okay, so this is the one way how to access this. So same class A, by using this class A we are going to access the class A member. That is the thing I want to discuss here. Okay, so we can access by using the inheritance. So it's a static member can access by the subclass name, and non-static member can access by using the object. So here we can use by so we have a class A and class B. I'm going to extend. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to access by using B subclass. So class B A a static, and class this I've created object of subclass. So we are going to access. So previous example, I access by using the class A, and now we are going to access class, you know, subclass by using the inheritance and without inheritance. Has a relationship, is a relationship. Okay, compiler and JVM activity. Okay, so some when you are doing the performing the inheritance, so how this compiler and JVM is working internally, you know, with respect to inheritance. Okay, so what happened when you are performing, when you are executing by using this any inheritance, so internally what is going to happen while compiling class with respect to with inheritance relationship, then I compile this code, the first compile the subclass, then it compile first compile the superclass, then it compile the subclass. Okay, first it will compile superclass, then it will compile subclass. It get superclass name from extend keyword. How to define it is the super or sub by using the extend keyword. In finding the method and variable definition, compiler always search in the first subclass. Okay, compilation is going to happen, but what happen, some method and variables are there, then what in this condition, finding the method and variable definition, compiler always search first in the subclass. If it is not available in that class, it will search in the immediate parent class, next in the grandparent class. So how is compiler is going to do, if you have a variable and if you have a method, so how this compiler is going to do, it will search in the subclass, again it is not there, it will go for the next class, again it will not go, again it will go to the next class. So I will show you in the example. Okay, so same thing, performing the inheritance, how it is working this. Okay, if there is not available and compiler throw cannot find the symbol, same thing happened with JVM also. Okay, so JVM also execute invoke member from the subclass. If that member definition is not found, then subclass, then it will search from the superclass until it is found. So some important stuff, I think I already discussed this all the things. Okay, class loading order in the form of superclass to subclass, so we have already discussed this, right? So static variable and static block are identified and execute from superclass to subclass. Object creation also start from superclass to subclass. Sub void means a non-static variable, non-static block and invoke constructor are identified and execute from superclass to subclass. So we have already seen in the execution flow. For executing method and its definition, searching from a start from subclass to superclass. How JVM can load superclass when subclass is loaded using extend keyword, right? Means subclass is loaded, how the JVM is load superclass by using the extend keyword, that is fine. How JVM can create superclass non-static variable and initialize in the subclass object. Actually what I want to tell you in this thing, We'll again read this question. How JVM can create a superclass non-static variable memory and initialize in the subclass? So we have a super call. Okay, so coming session I will discuss constructor with super call. How this super call is there. So by using this super call, you know, non-static variable are getting initialized and getting the memory. So this thing I will discuss in the super class and constructor, so it will get more clarity. Okay, so same thing, same example with inheritance, but this is not new for you guys. This is simple example performing the inheritance, but I want to show you how it is going to work. So I will save this class, this one. So we have a multiple relationship, extend class A, B and C. Here what happened, I am going to access this A variable. Okay, I am going to access this A variable. Then what happened, this, if you will execute this code, this class is loaded into the JVM. Then after that main method will execute, then here it will come. Okay, your control will come here. Then this is the C dot A. Then again the control will go and find this A variable. Where it is this A variable? Then in this line will execute, C is a class name and A is the variable. Then compiler will search this A variable, where it is there. Then the control will come inside this. Okay, so it will search here, it is A is there or not. No, this block A is not there. Then compiler will search in this block, not A is not there. If compiler is able to find this, then again the control will come back. Okay, so here we will display the A value. How this, you have a multiple inheritance, then how we are going to how this compiler and JVM is going to work this. Okay, again you can see I want to same thing, the B, then again it will go in the compiler, control will go here. Okay, then control will go here, again will search this B variable, it is not there. Again it will search here, it is not there, it is there. Here the compiler will get, and again the control will come back like that, and it will come here and it will display. And also check it is a static or non-static. It is a static, and we are going to access by using this object. So like B also, it will also search same. Okay, like that. But if we have C dot D, but D variable is not there, so compiler will go and search in the all the subclasses, class C, class B and class A, but still not there, then it will throw this cannot find the symbol which is not available in your class. So like that, this is, you know, inheritance, with inheritance how it is going to work this. Okay, when you are performing the inheritance, how compiler and JVM is working. We have a one more concept that is called super keyword. So why we are using the super keyword and how to use the super keyword, we are going to discuss. Super is a keyword, right? I have given the list of the keyword in the Java, 48 keyword which is supporting in the Java. Inside this we have a one more keyword that is called super keyword. In Java, the keywords used to access super class member or constructor from subclass member or constructor. I told you now, we have a super class and subclass. That question I have given, how to getting the memory, right? For super class variable, non-static variable, I have given this. That is the solution of super call, but we are going to explore this super. Okay. So if you want to access the super class member or whatever the member variable and method and all is there, then it used to access super class member or constructor from subclass member or constructor. So what happened, this will not clear now, will come with the coding, all will get clear. Okay, so if you have a constructor, by default compiler is adding the super call. Okay, so I did not discuss the constructor also. So I will come with constructor, then we will use again super, then it will get all the clarity of this. So we have a two syntax of the super. One is called super call and one is called super dot. So it is used to call super class constructor from subclass constructor. Why I have written the word constructor? When you are creating any class, by default constructor is added by compiler. If constructor is there, definitely super call is also there. So that's why I'm mentioning the constructor. So what is the use of the constructor? The job of the constructor, we are going to initialize an object. I already mentioned here, right? This is your constructor. So this new keyword is creating an object, and this constructor is initializing an object. Okay, when we are creating an object, this part is called constructor. Okay, so if you both having the different job, new means creation, constructor means initialization. So new means creating an object and constructor means initializing an object. Okay, so we have a super dot. So this is why I have written this. Okay, so it is used to call super class constructor from subclass constructor. Simply, the super and super call and super dot, we are going to perform the super class member and how to going to access and how to going to call this all the members. So that's why we are learning this super call. Okay, so one more thing is that is called super dot. It is used to call super class variable and method from subclass member and constructor. Okay, so here super class variable and method, so where we will use this both keyword, I will show you. Okay, don't worry. Rules on the constructor and super call. So we have some rules for the constructor and super call. It must be placed only in constructor as a first statement. Okay, else it leads to be a compile time error. This is one simple example regarding this. So if you have a constructor, then super is also there. Okay, so I'll tell you this simple code, then you guys are able to understand regarding this super dot. So if I will change the class name, then I have to change all the things. File is currently open and added plus. Oh, why this? Okay, that's test is still. Two file is there, then what happened? I'm already open this. We can see constructor I did not discuss, just we will understand what is constructor, why we are using the constructor. By using the constructor, we are initializing an object. Constructor name and class name is same, that is called constructor. So constructor is created as a class level. Okay, we have created a constructor as a class level. Okay, this is the constructor A and this is your constructor B. Okay, and now I am going to create an object simply. So I did not add here super. Okay, here also I did not add the super, but when you will execute this, then same output will get without a constructor A and constructor B. If you will not create an object, then what happens? If I will not, I did not create an object, then what happens? Will get any output? Yeah, what output will come? Compile time error and what is Tell me what the output will come. We have a class constructor A and constructor B, and this is your main method class. If I will compile this, I did not create an object, then what the output will come? We will get any output here, compile time error, what else? I'm expecting the answer, anything.
No.
No output will come, right?
Yes.
Why no output will come?
We are not creating object.
Yeah, constructor, I told you now, constructor is also non-static member. In control flow, we had already discussed this thing, right? So constructor is already non-static. So if we will not create an object, then what happened? It won't be get memory. Yeah, we are not getting anything. Right? So when you will create an object, okay, then we are getting this. We are getting the memory and it is going to execute this. Okay. But in your mind it should come when you are, okay, extend keyword, that is fine. How this super class is going to execute this? So by default compiler is added super call. Okay, so by using this super call, this control will go here, here and here also. Okay, so super call means getting the, I will give you regarding more stuff where we will, this is the implicitly added, but where you will use explicitly super call. I am using or not using, same output is coming. Why we will use that? The compiler is already added, right? So why we will use this? Okay, so we have a parameterized and non-parameterized constructor. So in that condition, we have to use this super call. So we will discuss this. Okay. So now if I'm going to compile this, I commented, right? But still, why this output is coming? Which number it is coming? Error, super, or something. I did typo somewhere. Line number 4. Added by compiler. Yeah, commented, right? This one. Both place it is coming, should not come. Oh, sit. I missed this semicolon. This is called typo mistake. Okay, so now same output we are getting after adding this constructor. Okay, so this is one thing. Like another example also, we have this super. So same example, I use your object class. I think again I have to execute Eclipse, but it doesn't matter if you are using this, but it will execute. Definitely it will execute. Okay, so just I want to show you in object class also having this super call. Okay, so same thing, concept is the same. Just I have created, I want to show you in this object class also. So we have example, this object class, I have it super, then example class, and we have a variable. Again, I have created one constructor, same sample class, we have some variable, and again I have created a constructor. So same concept, I'm going to execute this. But here I have added also the object class also. I think it will execute. Okay, so same thing, that in the object class also super is there. And this is your constructor, object class. So in the object class, so object class itself is a, you know, super class in the Java. So if you are creating any class, by default object class is there. Okay, so that thing I want to show you, but everything is same. I'm not going to display any variables here, just I want to show you here in the object class. Also constructor is there and super call is there. Okay, so this, that's why I have written this. We have some rules of the super. We are not allowed to use super keyword in the static member. If you are using the super keyword in the static member, it leads to be a compile time error. So what the error will come? Non-static variable super cannot be referenced from the static context. It can be used in all non-static member only. Okay, so what is the meaning of super dot working functionality? So super dot is used to access super class variable and method from subclass member. Okay, so used to access super class variable and method from subclass member. It is mandatory to use super dot in accessing super class member only if the subclass member same name with the super class member. So same thing, example I have discussed when I was teaching the variable, right? So class level member, class level variable means a static and non-static variable and local variable are same. Then how to differentiate this? Here, same thing I am going to apply. If super class member or subclass member is same, then how to differentiate this? Okay, so this thing I am going to explain here. Okay, so we have a two class. One is your example class, one is your sample class. So in this class, you can see we have a variable, two non-static variable A and B. Okay, static variable A and B. Inside this subclass, same variable are there. Okay, and I have created one method. Now, how to access super class variable? Okay, so we have a non-static method. Then how to execute non-static method? We have to create an object and we can access this. Okay, we can create an object and we can access this. So here you can see, if I will execute M1, just I have commented this. So here, same variable name, then in your mind will come which variable will execute here. Means what the output will come. If I will compile this, the output will come 10 or 20 or 30 or 40. What the output will come?
30-40.
Okay. Yeah, your answer is correct. But someone will ask why it is not printing this one. So by default, compiler is adding this keyword. If you are adding or not adding, then by default the compiler is adding this keyword. The job of the this keyword, it will access current object, means what is the current variable are there here present inside this. So someone will ask how it is going to access in this. So you have an answer. Yeah, what happened if you are adding or not adding, by default compiler is adding this keyword. So because of this keyword, it is going to access this one, 30 and 40. But I want to access the super class member, then how to access? Yeah, we have a one more keyword that is called super dot. So by using this super dot, we are going to access 10 and 20. Okay. This is your 10 and 20. Actually, today my health is not good, so I'm not.